accepting everyone, taken from the book of Philemon. Paul, a prisoner of Jesus Christ, and Timothy, our brother, to Philemon, our dear friend and fellow worker, also to Apphia, our sister, and Archippus, our fellow soldier, and to the church that meets in your home, grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I always thank my God as I remember you in my prayers, because I hear about your love for all his holy people and your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray that your fellowship with us in the faith may be effective in deepening your understanding of every good thing we share for the sake of Christ. Your love has given me joy and encouragement, because you, brother, have refreshed the hearts of the Lord's people. Therefore, although in Christ I could be bold and older to you to do what you ought to do, yet I prefer to appeal to you on the basis of love. It is as none other than Paul, an old man, and now also prisoner of Jesus Christ, that I appeal to you for my son Onesimus, who became my son while I was in chains. Formerly, he was useless to you, but now he has become useful both to you and to me. A man named Ray was a dealer in illegal drugs, but meeting Christ brought radical changes in this drug dealer's life. He is now one of the church's most influential, vibrant members. Very smart, very neat, and social. Ray found quick acceptance and blended easily in church. One day, Ray brought with him two friends who were struggling drug dealers. They looked weird, had long dread hair with street clothing, and you could tell they were unfamiliar with church environments. As Ray introduced them to one of the elders in the church to greet them, she walked away without saying a word to them. Their suspicion was that this is not a place for people like us. Yet Jesus built his ministry based on including everyone. The fellowship of believers is intended to be a place of acceptance, healing, forgiveness, and equality. In a short letter, Paul urges Philemon and his church to restore their membership of a runaway slave called Onesimus. Philemon was an affluent man, a leader of a fellowship that met in his home. He came to the Lord through Paul's ministry. Years later, Onesimus, a maid servant of Philemon, robbed him and ran away. But on his run, he met Paul in prison in Rome. There, he gave his life to Christ and changed his heart. But Onesimus has a past to deal with as he leaves prison to return home to meet his angry master. In Mosaic law, escaped slaves were not accepted back home. Slaves were treated as property and no rights to marry, and sometimes killed on crosses. Paul writes a beautiful letter telling Philemon to receive Onesimus and promises to pay what is due. Paul urges Philemon to do the right thing in forgiving Onesimus and to set an example for the church that met in his home. Forgive others not because they deserve forgiveness, but because God in Christ also forgave us. Let no man pull you so low enough to hate him. Be strong enough to forgive. The weak can never forgive. Forgiveness is the attribute of the strong. Paul opens the letter with a soft tone, thanking the church that met in Philemon's home. He then connects with a humble plea in verse 10 to 12. I appeal to you for my son Onesimus, who became my son while I was in chains. Formerly, he was useless to you, but now he has become useful both to you and to me. Paul approaches a matter of reconciliation with maturity, not using his authority as a bishop to overstep Philemon's leadership. The practice of peace and reconciliation is one of the most important virtues in our society. Reconciliation after breakup is the highest gesture of maturity. Paul says in verse 17, if you consider me a partner, welcome him as you would welcome me. He also emphasizes, I'm writing with my own hand. This was an important cause to reconcile. Tradition indicates that Philemon was received back by Onesimus. He made him free as Paul requested, and years later, Onesimus became a bishop in Berea. An exclusive attitude could have made him lose a bishop. There are many people who do not look like us that need to be welcomed in the fellowship this week. Will you welcome them? Will you make them feel home in your church, company, and home? Courteous treatment will make a stranger your walking advertisement. Learn to receive people the way they are. Thank you for coming on our platform. My name is Patrick Chizito, Living Word Community Church. God bless you.